Hey traders, David Frost, LazyGapTrader.com. In this video, we're talking about day trading. More specifically, we're talking about gap trading. And in this video, I'm going to show you how on a day when the market is absolutely getting killed, we come up with six positive trades that were all given out before the market even opened for trading. I'm going to get into each and every trade and explain exactly what happened. You're looking at a preview of one of them on the screen, which was Darden Restaurants, DRI. We actually got two trades on this stock today. But first, let me explain exactly what gap trading is. As traders, we need opportunity. In order to get opportunity, we need stocks to be moving at the open. When stocks are moving, it creates opportunity. That creates profits for traders. When stocks are gapping higher or lower at the open, the opportunity is for traders that can identify a specific price where these stocks will first be drawn to like a magnet and then have a price reaction from in the other direction. In my course at Lazy Gap Trader, traders learn all the specific criteria that we're looking for in order to be profitable. What type of stocks does this work the best with? What type of volume on these stocks are we looking for? How much of a gap higher or lower are we looking for in the morning? How do you trade them? What type of profit target are we looking for? What type of stop loss limitation are we looking for? And most importantly, and this is the holy grail, how do you calculate the specific price levels where these stocks will first be drawn to and then have that price reaction in the other direction? That's how profits are made. All this and a whole lot more is taught in the course at Lazy Gap Trader. Now, the other thing I do is give traders an opportunity to get my list sent to them each and every morning at 9 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 30 minutes before the market's even opened for business. Here's a copy of my gap trading list that was sent to traders' inboxes at 9:01 a.m. You can see the timestamp on the screen. This morning, we had 8 potential gap trades on the board. Now, out of this 8, we had 6 profitable trades hit. I'm going to go through this list real quick, and then we'll get back to the charts and identify exactly what happened on each individual trade. The first one was GIII, gap lower. Support levels are 33.71 and 32.19, and then I gave a third level. Stop and profit target is about 30 to 55 cents. These are minimum profit targets. There are plenty of times where we get a whole lot more out of these trades. The second stock that hit a price level today was JKS, gap lower. Support levels are 18.71, and then I gave 2 secondary support levels. Stop and profit target is about 20 to 40 cents. Again, minimum profit targets. These are scalp trades that most of the time turn into day trades, but we're looking for at minimum of a minimum profit target in order to put money in our pocket. And in my course, I teach traders how to let the rest run in a risk-free, emotionless trade. We'll get back to that when we get back to the charts. Then we had BZUN, gap lower. Support levels are 45.94, 44.26, and 42.57. Stop and profit target is about 30 to 55 cents. Again, these are minimums. Next up, we had Darden Restaurants, DRI, gap lower. Support levels are 88.19, 86.79, and 85.38. These are all separate and independent trade levels from one another, and that will become clear when we get back to the charts. Stop and profit target is about 35 to 65 cents. Again, these are minimum profit targets. And then the last one on the board, GES, G-E-S, gap higher. Resistance levels are 18.37 and 19.62. Stop and profit target is about 20 to 35 cents. We're going to pay close attention to this one because there is a learning opportunity on this trade on GES, G-E-S. The first chart we're going to take a look at is GIII. As you can see, the stock closed yesterday at $37.50. The stock was getting a nice haircut at the open, qualifying for one of our morning gap trade opportunities. Now, the first level at 33.71, you can see here, the stock came very close to it. The stock came making a low of $33.75, had a little bounce, then traded through that level. But the most important thing that we have to note is, and traders learn this in the course, that when a stock consolidates over a particular level, it changes the probabilities of that price level. So this trade was actually off the table at 33.71. However, as you can see, the stock went lower and came into the $32.19 level. Look what happened. The stock made a low of $32.06, now is running higher as we speak, as I make this video, already giving us well above the minimum profit target. This is a stock that may go a lot farther throughout the trading day. This is a wonderful profit opportunity. Next up, we'll take a look at Jinko Solar, JKS. As you can see, the stock closed yesterday at $20.22, getting its haircut at the open, qualifying for one of our morning gap trades. The first level that you saw from the email was $18.71. And look what happened. The stock in the first 10-minute candle of the day made a low of exactly $18.71, had a tremendous rip higher off that level, and you can see in the next 10-minute candle of the day, the stock made a high of $19.35. That qualifies for at least our minimum profit target, another positive trade. And by the way, over a 60-cent bounce on an $18 or $19 stock represents about 3.5%, and that's just in a matter of minutes. We do this each and every day, over and over and over again. Next stock on the board was BZUN. The stock closed yesterday at $50.49. The stock was trading lower at the open, obviously went lower, came into our 45.94 level and had a bounce. Now that happened all the way down here, as you can see, making a low of $45.90, just 4 pennies below the specified level, and then it got the bounce, making a high in the next candle of 46.47. So that qualified for our minimum profit target. The stock actually came back in, but look where it is now, having a nice rip higher at $46.65. These are very, very important price levels to these stocks. Traders that take the course learn exactly why these price levels are so important to these stocks. This goes to show you the power and importance of these price levels. It changes your outlook on trading because traders understand why this works. That's extremely important. When traders understand why this works, it changes their outlook on trading. It takes the guesswork away from trading, and it gives them the confidence to take these trades because they have a certain expectation of what is going to and should happen at these specific price levels. How about Darden Restaurants, DRI? You can see here the stock closed yesterday at $93.91. Stock was getting killed at the open, came right into our first price level, making a low of $87.90, well within the stop loss limitation. Next candle high was $89.75. That's a tremendous bounce off the first level, tremendous trade. What happened? The stock rolled over, came into the second level down at $86.79. You can see right now it's trading well above that level, $86.27. It's already made another high of $86.49. Those are two trades on Darden Restaurants in the same day. That happens more than you would think. It happens over and over and over again, which is specifically why I give multiple support levels on these stocks, because we do get multiple trades on the same stock in the same day. This stock isn't done yet. We'll probably trade higher yet off the second price level. Now here we're looking at a chart of Guess, GES. And here's the learning opportunity, because we had two price levels on Guess, 1837 and 1962. You can see what happened. The stock closed yesterday all the way down at $15.53. The stock was getting a nice boost higher at the open. So what we're looking for on this particular stock are resistance levels. Where is this stock going to find resistance, giving traders an opportunity to short the stock for a pullback? When we came into the first level at 1837, we actually came up a penny short. You can see the high in this candle was $18.36. The stock had a pullback from that level, and what that does is it takes the first level off the table. We want the stock to come straight into our level, either hit the level or spike through it by a little bit, and then have the pullback. When we miss by a penny and have a pullback, that changes the probabilities of the trade. Therefore, this trade, or the $18.37 price, was off the table. So what do? We look to the second level, $19.62. What happened? The stock came right into $19.62, piercing through it by 2 pennies. 1964 was the high, and just minutes later, the stock was already at a low of $19.09, giving us much more than the minimum profit target specified in the email that went out a half an hour before the market even opened for trading. Then the stock consolidated and it traded higher, but that's okay. This trade was over. We got the profit we were looking for from the $19.62 level. Folks, you just saw how 6 trades that were given out before the market even opened for business worked out on a day when the Dow at the time was down 500 points, the S&P was down 45 or 50 points, the market was getting slaughtered, and we were putting money in our pocket trade after trade after trade when most traders were losing money on a day like today. This is a strategy that you need to learn that you can use each and every day for the remainder of your trading career. Learn the why behind this strategy. Once you understand why this works, it will change your trading forever. I'm David Frost, Lazy Gap Trader. Thanks for tuning in, folks.